In this video, we're going to talk about the convolve operator in details. I'm going to step by step, and we are going to do all the calculations by hand. And then we are going to study that in Python programming language using the NumPy package. So please stay tuned. So first of all, suppose that we have two vectors, vector 1 and vector 2, and we want to convolve these two vectors together. And maybe you ask, what is the meaning of convolve operator? In order to understand what is the meaning of convolve operator, you should wait a minute, because we are going to study an example. And after that example, you will find out the meaning of convolve operator. So here we have a vector, vector 1, which is a red vector. And also we have a black vector, and we want to convolve these together. The general idea of the convolve operator in this example, which is a one-dimensional and discrete convolve operator, so in this example, the general idea is sliding this vector from left to right and multiplying each values. And maybe you ask, what is the meaning? Again, you should wait a minute, because after the example, you will find out the meaning. So let's start. And as you can see, there is no values in these places, so we cannot multiply 1 divided by 3 by this value and 1 divided by 3 by this value, because there is no value. But here we have a value, so we multiply 10 by 1 divided by 3, which leads to 10 divided by 3. And let's write it beside the page. As you can see, 10 divided by 3. And also let's append that to a list. This list is going to represent the values of different steps. This is step number 1, and the value is 10 divided by 3. So let's go to the next step, which we are going to slide this vector to the right. We are going to slide this vector one block to the right. And now in this step, as you can see, we don't have such value here, but we have values here. So 10 times 1 divided by 3 is 10 divided by 3. And also 11 times 1 divided by 3 is 11 divided by 3. And if you sum these values, you will get 21 divided by 3. And you append that to the list. So this is the value for the first step. And this is the value for the current step, which is step number 2. And now let's again slide this vector to the right, one block to the right. As you can see, here we can multiply each values. So 10 divided by 3, 11 divided by 3, 12 divided by 3. And if you sum these values, you will get 33 divided by 3. And we append that to that list. And again, let's slide it to the right again. So now we are going to multiply it, 11 divided by 3, 12 divided by 3, 5 divided by 3. And if you sum these values, you will get 28 divided by 3. And we are going to append that to the list. And again, we are going to slide this vector to the right. So we are going to multiply values. And this is the summation of these values. And we are going to append that to the list. And also, again, we are going to do the same for the rest. So as you can see, this is the final result. The final result of sliding that red vector and multiplying values. And if we do the calculations, this is the final result. 10 divided by 3 is equal to 3.3. 21 divided by 3 equals to 7. 33 divided by 3 is 11, and etc. So this is the convolve operator. And remember that the convolve operator has different modes. And the thing that we have talked so far is the full mode. I mean, we are calculating all the possible cases. So we are sliding this vector to the right, and we are calculating all the possible cases. But there is another mode called valid, which, for example, this case is not valid for this mode. Why? Because in this case, we don't have such values. Of course, in the full mode, there is no problem and you can do the calculations. But in the valid mode, this case is not allowed, because you don't have two values in order to multiply. So remember that this case is allowed in the full mode, but not in the valid mode. In the valid mode, it is going to start from this case, which you can see you can multiply all the values together. So in the valid mode, you're going to start from this case, and you're going to multiply these two values, and then you're going to slide to the right, slide to the right, slide to the right, and slide to the right. And this is the final case which you are allowed in the valid mode. You cannot shift anymore, because that is not going to be valid. And if you do the calculations, you will get these values for sliding the red vector to the right. And now let's do all the calculations in Python programming language using the NumPy package. So first of all, we import NumPy as in P. Then we define two vectors, vector 1 and vector 2. Vector 1 is the 1 divided by 3, 1 divided by 3, 1 divided by 3. And vector 2 is the numbers. So we have defined two vectors, vector 1 and vector 2. And we want to convolve these two vectors together. And now we simply type np.convolve, because you want to convolve these two vectors. So we are going to pass vector 1, which is our first vector, then vector 2, which is the second vector. And for example, suppose that we want to calculate the full convolution. So we are going to pass mode equals to full. And for example, we store the result in a variable, let's say called result. And if we print the result variable, the result variable, and if I run the code, and now we can see here is the result, which is exactly the same to those things we have seen in the slides. And now let's convolve these two vectors with the valid mode. So I should pass valid, and if I run the code, you can see here is the result, which is again exactly the same to those things we have seen in the slides.